Hey guys, so today we're going to be going over something very basic but it's going to go a long way in terms of your electrical system maintenance. Now today's example is an anti-corrosive gel. It's pretty much the same as dielectric grease. We're not going to be talking about conductive grease at all. We're just talking about this type. Conductive grease typically has little metal particles in them. This type of gel that I'm talking about does not. Now, keep in mind also, dielectric grease is technically, yes, it is an insulator, but it does help electrical connections maintain the same performance. And we're regarding this in an automotive application. Now you really want to read your owner's manual before you start slathering this stuff on any electrical device. I don't recommend that. So read your owner's manual. This is strictly an automotive application, typically on plugs on the outside of the vehicle that are subjected to wear elements like moisture and dirt and things like that. Now for most parts in your car, they're easy to maintain because there's some sort of lubricant to maintain the part, like your engine oil, for example. When it comes to wiring, however, you can't really maintain it. All you can do is just protect the wire that's already there. Now, if you ever were to see wiring, you can see here, here's a good example. This was under the hood of a car for an amp. It was never soldered at the end, so there's nothing, this wire was completely exposed to the elements with nothing on it. You see here, this part was under the fuse as well, so you have a better idea what the wire looked like. You see it's starting to turn blackish. Here you can really see it's really discolored. That's normal, that's just corrosion that's happening to the wire. But there are ways to either slow down the corrosion or eliminate it altogether by using some sort of product like this. All the dielectric grease does is separate the wire from the elements like moisture or dirt. You can see it's just a clear type of grease. And sometimes it might have like a golden brownish look to it. And all you really have to do is just put a little bit down and just massage it in and work it into the wiring. It is a bit messy, but to protect your wires, that's typically all you have to do. Now remember when you saw me put on the ring on the end that was basically where the wire was exposed to elements, that's where I focused the dielectric grease to insulate the wire. Now if you're gonna do it on the connector side, like say a plug in a vehicle, I wouldn't put it in here because it is an insulator, so there might be cases where you actually make it worse, but then it's never gonna corrode. But usually on the inside of these plugs, the wires are actually pretty well sealed. Typically that's how the connectors are designed under the hood. But what might be exposed is the back portion. So by putting some dielectric grease on the back portion where you're not making the contact to the other end of the car, this is where I put the dielectric grease because that's what's gonna be exposed on some connectors to the elements, it's going to start corroding. So remember, just on parts that are exposed to the elements, you want to focus the dielectric grease. You don't want to be stuffing on connection to connection if you can help it, because technically it isn't good for it. Now, how about for your ignition system? It is a widely used application for dielectric grease to be used on spark plug wires and spark plugs. But what most people do is they just slather a bunch on the tip and then put the spark plug wire back on. You don't actually want to do this. You actually want to have the metal-to-metal connection not have anything on it, especially dielectric grease, because like, as we discussed before, it is technically an insulator. But what it is good for is because there's arcing that's going on, you want to keep the arcing only in the plug and the wire. So what you can do is, on the inside of the boot, not on the metal part, take a cotton swab and put a very little amount of dielectric grease in here, and then the ceramic portion, also put a little bit of dielectric grease, but make sure you don't put any here. That way you make sure that the spark is only going to travel through the spark plug and into the combustion chamber. Battery connectors, again, a great place to put the stuff, because typically I see a lot of cars, especially with cheaper batteries, you get a lot of corrosion on the terminal. So putting dielectric grease on all your battery connections between the alternator and ground on the battery will help everything last a lot longer too. And then you'd also want to go on the connectors on the alternator as well, where the main power hooks up. Now here's the part of the video where I contradict myself, where I said don't put the dielectric grease on the connectors. When it comes to your trailer connector, go ahead and lather it up. So here's my 4-pin. I do have dielectric grease in there because I don't use it that often. I'm trying to protect it. And there is a thin coating all over in my 7-way. Now, we have practiced this for years, just putting dielectric grease on this connector, because it does get exposed even with the connector. It's not exactly the tightest, so we find that our trailer brakes always work. And this is a good way to protect it, especially if you're dunking your trailer or the rear half of your vehicle into water when you're towing a boat. So before I get all the trolling comments and everything, I'm going to put this all at rest to show you what dielectric grease can and cannot do. So we know that cardboard does not conduct. I'm going to touch on my power supply here. I have it connected, so we're now going to read. This is at DC voltage at the 20 setting. So touching metal, I have 12.77 volts. To cardboard, I have no reading. Okay, I have 0.01 of a reading on this cardboard. It is conducting a little bit. Now, we know water conducts. It's 12 volts, so it is safe. See, touching the cardboard over here, no tricks. Just cardboard, we are registering 12.04-ish volts. So we are getting a reading. Now we're gonna do a piece of cardboard again, but we're gonna use dielectric grease on it to see if dielectric grease actually conducts electricity. So test again on a metal, 12.77, 12.78, onto cardboard. Again, we register 0.01 off the multimeter. So we're going to say 0.01 is our zero reading. We have no reaction. See, nothing on it. It's a little bit of water on the back side. We're going to go on the dry part, dielectric grease. Dielectric grease is now touching, and we're going to put a little bit on top too. Give it every possible chance to conduct. So on cardboard, now we're in the dielectric grease, we're not changing readings, a little bit by touching the cardboard, nothing that will actually suggest conducting. Now, stated that it is an insulator, we're going to see if we actually lost any voltage on the actual alligator clip here, and touching it again. Now we have no degradation in performance. We actually see a little bit of a performance improvement at 12.78. So the argument saying that it makes the connection worse, based on this we can say no. So it would be okay to put it inside a connector if you think you had to, but we're showing here the actual grease by itself does not conduct. But going on contact to contact, like an actual electrical connection, it's actually pretty good for it, it looks like. So just make sure you're aware of how to use this product. Its main purpose is to insulate and keep moisture out. That's why people put it on certain parts of the distributor on a vehicle to make sure parts don't stick. They're put on spark plug boots to make sure that the boot doesn't fuse to the ceramic portion on the spark plug. That's its main purpose. So hopefully you guys learned something today.